So my friends, this is the 60 frames per second version of my previous video. This is a video designed to help you detect any problems that you might have with your TV. We'll look at motion handling, we'll also look at running some dirty screen effect tests so that you can pick up problems like defective LEDs, and also look at burn-in. Don't forget to hit the red button to subscribe and give this video a thumbs up and click the notification bell to get my next video first. So guys, as well as the obvious burn-in and image retention, the things that you ought to be looking out for are dark marks in the corner or anywhere else on the screen. You'll notice on this Sony TV, the four corners have got a dark little shadow. Now, for the price I paid for this TV, it wasn't too bad. However, this TV, which was a Samsung, it was around £6,000 or £7,000. It was just a loan that was sent to me, but look at that terrible mark in the middle. Now that mark actually appeared over time, so I recommend that you run this video or a similar video at least once a month, because you'll be able to then spot any degradation in the screen. Okay guys, the other thing I'd love you to do is leave a comment in the section below what model TV you've got and how well did it do on the test. Okay, it starts now. So we'll start off with some shapes moving around the screen. This should show the dimming zones on the TV if you do have them, and it should highlight any dirty screen effect. You'll also get an idea of the motion capability of the TV and how well it handles motion, and obviously blooming. Now, if you do want to mute this video while this video is playing, then obviously just go ahead and then you can see how well your TV has done. But I recommend that you do this whether you've got a new TV or an old TV, because older TVs sometimes can surprise at how good they are. And certainly if you've got a new TV, then do this immediately, because any problems should be highlighted. And sometimes those problems don't show up in the first few days of ownership, and it can be quite difficult with some shops to then return the TV at a later date. Any of you had any problems with that? Certainly I did when I returned a Sony TV last year. It was something which the person that I spoke to on the phone didn't even understand what the problem was, and it was dirty screen effect was the reason for sending it back. So a lot of these tests will look at motion and blooming, but we'll come on to subtitle tests in a minute, running across the bottom. A lot of things have subtitles nowadays. And then finally, at the end of this, there'll be screens of colour so that you can see is there any image retention. And obviously that will highlight you to a potential problem maybe in the future. So this is a clip from a video that I made last year, and it shows you the dirty screen effect on the TV. And as you can see, there's almost like this grid type pattern, which you wouldn't necessarily notice if you're watching standard TV, but it becomes very clear on clear color screens. Okay, let's run the colors now, and you can then let me know in the comments how well your TV did. Now, hopefully when you run this test, you won't see anything on your TV at all, and it'll be completely clear, a completely clean screen, just with different colors. What I found in my experience is that OLED TVs tend to be the best and don't tend to have any dirty screen. I've not seen one OLED TV in the last 2 or 3 years that's got a problem. The only thing that you may get maybe on some older TVs is image retention or burn-in. So let me know about that too. But guys, I hope this video has been helpful, and make sure you run it regularly on your TV. Thanks for watching. Give us a thumbs up if you have liked it, and leave a comment letting me know what your TV was and how well did it do in this test.